Hey VC, I wasn't planning on doing a video this weekend, but yesterday I got a package from one of my best friends, Jay and Tracy in California. It's a pretty big package. I already opened it yesterday. I couldn't wait to see what was in it, so about to show you what's in here. I just woke up from a nap. I mowed half the backyard. Which is very large, but it's 98 degrees outside right now. We're going through a heat wave, and I just took a nap, so it wore me out. So I apologize if I seem a little groggy. Anyway, he sent me a package, which blows me away because Jay and Tracy have been through a lot this year. Part of their house burned down earlier this year in California, so they've had a really rough time. I just can't even imagine, but I've known Jay since 2001. We've been really good friends since then. We actually met online, just I think on a music message board. Sorry Jay, I don't quite remember exactly what website or board we met on, but we're huge Julianne Hatfield fans, and he likes basically all the same type of music I do. Group Assault. He's big into the John Spencer blues explosion. Lots of blues like Albert King, Stevie Ray Vaughan. The list goes on and on. So we really bond on music, and we've just been like really close friends. I've only seen him and hung out with him in person probably 3 or 4 times since 2001. And last time I saw him and Tracy was in 2014 when we went to see Rube Assol at the Roxy in LA. It was a reunion show. It was awesome. But anyway, Jay's always there for me. We text a lot. Just that type of quality friend that I'm thankful to have. So he sent me a package. And now when I was there in 2014, we went to Amoeba in LA. Amoeba Records, that is. A huge, awesome store. Music store. And we also went to Dr. Strange, which is a really cool punk store, and Matt Hayes just did a video. Go check out his video. He went to Dr. Strange a little bit ago. But when I went there, I found like a Depeche Mode bootleg DVD. In fact, where is it? Hang on, you guys. This might be kind of shaky. There we go. I bought this there. See that? Still has a sticker on it. And I also bought a Depeche Mode shirt, a really cool shirt. So yeah, I found some cool stuff. I really liked the store, but he went back and he talked to one of the guys who works there who's very knowledgeable. Jay knows that two of my favorite punk bands are The Gits, which I did a whole video on The Gits if you want to check it out. And X, they're another one of my favorite punk bands. I'm not really into the typical punk bands, I guess a lot of people are in. Chris really likes Suicidal Tendencies, Black Flag, Circle Jerks, stuff like that. I'm not really into those kind of bands, but I really like X, The Damned, The Gits, The Ramones, stuff like that. Anyway, so based on these two bands, X and The Gits, Jay was talking to the guy at the store, and I guess the guy kind of said, oh, if she's into those bands, she may like these ones. By the way, here's two really cool stickers. So yeah, if you're ever in Southern California, definitely check Dr. Strange out, especially if you're into punk. If you're not into punk, you probably won't like this video, okay? So go ahead and skip over it. I'm not offended at all. I can't imagine what Jay spent on all this stuff, by the way. But he wrote me out a really nice long letter kind of explaining what this stuff is. So I'm just gonna get started. By the way, in the background, I'm playing something he sent, and that's The Best of Penetration. I had never heard of any of these bands, by the way. So both of these bands, they started out in the late 70s, and they're British punk bands. Okay, so The Best of Penetration, The singer is Pauline Murray. I really like her voice. Actually, I liked it from the first song I started playing. And I just started playing this morning because I got this package yesterday. So anyway, they had their original run in the late 70s, and then they reformed in 2014 and recorded this new disc called Resolution, which is still sealed. I haven't opened this one yet because I'm still listening to the best of. But yeah, if you can hear it in the background, and if you like this kind of stuff, I mean, it's late 70s British punk with a chick singer. It's pretty good. Okay. And then there's three LPs in here. So let me get those out so I can finally put this box down. Okay. So the first one I'm going to show is Pauline Murray's solo album. Now, she originally was in Penetration, which I'm playing now. So later on, she did Pauline Murray and the Invisible Girls. And this came out in 1980, recorded at Strawberry Studios North. It's cool, right? Let's show the label here. Poly Inner Sleeve. Elusive Records. See that. I'm excited to listen to this. Let me refer back to the note to what he said about this. I'm still trying to learn about these bands myself. So yeah, after Penetration broke up, she did this solo record with a punk supergroup, The Invisible Girls, produced by Joy Division and New Order producer and keyboardist. And one of the Buzzcocks was actually in this band. So does it say the lineup on here? It doesn't. Sorry, you guys. So I don't know which Buzzcock is in the band here. But anyways, Penetration and Pauline Murray. I'm so excited to listen to all of this stuff. Okay, so the next two records he sent me are from a band called Vice Squad. Here's Vice Squad, The Riot City Years. That's a cool cover, right? So this release looks like this came out in 2017, but it looks like they recorded these from 79 through 83, it looks like. So here's the back. I'm really excited to listen to this. Now, I think the singer's name is Becky Bondage or something like that. Let me refer to the notes here. Yeah, and so this next record I'm going to show, which is still sealed, I haven't opened these, it's Vice Squad's Shot Away. Now, this record, they have a different female singer. Leah is her name. Oh yeah, another side note is he said that the original singer of Vice Squad, Becky Bondage, she was a huge animal rights supporter and activist to the point where she was slightly militant about it, which caused a rift in the band because, you know, while the members supported her, she didn't feel they were dedicated enough, so she decided to leave. And then the band recorded this album with Leah. However, Becky came back after this record, apparently. Okay, and here's the back of that, Shot Away. I had never heard of these bands, and that's what, you know, makes music in general fun, is that there's so many bands to discover out there and listen to that you're never gonna get bored. That's why I like music. So Jay and Tracy were kind enough to send these to me. I am super grateful. All I'm able to really send them is a custom loaf of soap that they want. I'm gonna make them a lilac and vanilla soap that Tracy wants. So I'm gonna have to figure out what else I can do to repay them. But yeah, I just really value their friendship. Dear friends, wonderful people. So I wanted to show you guys this stuff in case you wanted to check them out for yourself. I'll probably do an update after I listen to everything. So yeah, hopefully you guys like this video. And if you're ever in Southern California, do visit Dr. Strange Records if you're into punk. For sure. All right, you guys. Have a good one. Peace.